scholars know virtually nothing about Jane Anger's life. She is known only as the author of The Writing Protection for Women, in 1589, and the first female author published a full-length defense of her gender in English. In the late 16th century, it must be considered exceptional or revolutionary for women to write and publish on secular or non-religious themes and argue against male supremacy. Professional scholars have suggested, with some justification, that Jane Anger was the pseudonym of a male writer. Her Protection for Women was addressed explicitly to an audience of other women. It was probably the first book-length defense of women's place in society to be published in English. Only one copy of the original pamphlet still exists. Stunning text parallels between Jane Anger's Protection for Woman and Nicholas Breton's Praise of Virtuous Ladies allow only one plausible and logic conclusion. The author Breton, an absolute safe pseudonym of the true Shakespeare, must be identical with the alleged female author Jane Anger, that is, she must be the tricky, female, pseudonymous counterpart of Nicholas Breton. Unbelievable? Just reflect one of eight examples. Furthermore, be aware that the text of Jane Anger contains stunning text parallels to idioms in Shakespeare's plays and poems. English professor Lynn Magnuson from Toronto in 1993 discovered and published stunning text parallels between Jane Anger's Protection for Woman and Nicholas Breton's Praise for Virtuous Ladies. Only those who are fully aware of the impressive literary oeuvre of Nicholas Breton can, and will, have no doubt that both texts must have sprung from the same brain. Jane Anger must have been taken as a tricky female pseudonym of Nicholas Breton, that is, of the true Shakespeare. Reflect the following selected example, one out of eight text comparisons between Anger's Protection for Woman and Breton's Praise of Virtuous Ladies.
Jane Anger. We are necessary. But they would have us, likewise evil.
Breton. Some will say, a woman is a necessary evil.
Anger. I grant, yet evil I deny. Except only in the respect of man who hating all good things, in estimation of conceit, we are made ill.
Breton. I grant, but evil, I deny. Except it be meant only in respect of man, that desireth, not anything, that is good, and so his desire makes her ill, in estimation of mind.
Jane Anger. That none is good, but God, and therefore, woman are ill, I must yield, that in that respect, we are ill, and affirm, that men are no better.
Breton. That there is none good, but God, so indeed, I must yield, that woman is ill, and man, no better.
Jane Anger. Seeing. We are so necessary unto them, if we be ill, they are worse, they, that use ill worth, than it should be, are worse than the ill.
Breton. But, whether may man be thought worse than ill, that will use that ill, than it should be.
Can anyone assume that the following multiple text parallels of idioms and of word contexts happen purely accidental? And that the true Shakespeare borrowed from Jane Eyre to such an extent and in such a short text?